In today's fast-paced, hard-hitting consumer markets, only the best quality products will suffice. With so many similar products available in all areas of market, manufacturers can't rely on quality alone. They must also go for the hard sell. What's up, everyone? My name is Al-Philippe Sinoy. Welcome to The Making of Hard. We're going to be looking at what goes into making a quality TV advert, which is essential in today's competitive consumer arena. Making a TV commercial is no simple task. The consumer group must be analyzed, the script and storyboards conceived, and the cast and crew chosen. All that before even shooting begins. As part of the technical crew, I'll guide you through the processes involved in developing the hard commercial. For the moment, I pass you on to Martin Pampel, the director of the crew.
Strictly speaking, the director is the person who is responsible for how the advert looks, sounds, moves and how the actors perform. As the director, it was my job to conceive a vision for this advert. I decided upon a day in the lifespan of a famous sports star, illustrating how the drink helps him in all areas of his life, including his sports performances. The crew for this TV advert included Richard Clifford, Dan Cablett, Lo Devalone, Ben Smith and Tim Wilkinson. All in all, it's a long and arduous process, working long hours, which is extremely stressful. But all the same, it's just great fun working with the team and bringing our fantasy into reality.
Choosing the actor required much thought. The director had called for a famous sports star who had a strong influence on his fans. All the possible candidates were eventually shortlisted to four possibilities. But who was the right man for the job? Let's look at the four contestants. First up was Mike Wilkes, a talented skateboarder, but did skateboarding have the necessary appeal? John Cal, extreme martial arts competitor, he had the moves, but did the fans have the money? Basketball star Derek Boykin, basketball is a popular sport, and Derek was a strong contender right from the start. Finally, Dom Hafner, always a hit with the ladies, but skiing lacks year-round appeal. Eventually, it was basketball star Derek Boykin who was selected. Let's see what he has to say about being chosen to be the hard man.
I'm Derek Boykin from Brooklyn, New York, born and raised. At present, I'm here at the University of Sussex in Brighton, England. I'm studying international relations and politics. It's a great course. As a matter of fact, this is my second master's degree. As the advert says, I believe in working hard. Yo, it's just an incredible experience overall. Basically, I've been playing basketball for the last, well, God knows how long, but since 7 years old, you know, it's been an incredible experience. Yo, as far as this advert is concerned, I know it's gonna be fabulous. The kids I'm working with are really cool. They're working really hard, trying to make it great, you know. The only thing I ask them to do is make me look as beautiful as possible.
Now that we met the actor and the crew, let's look at what we did to make that advert. The creation of the advert can be split into three distinct parts. Pre-production, dealing with the planning and organizational issues of the shoot. Filming, committing the action to celluloid. And post-production, editing the footage and adding sound and effects. Let's have a look at pre-production. Part 1, pre-production. This is an essential phase of production. Proper planning is crucial for the production to run smoothly and stay on budget. Lots of paperwork was involved, but the crew were not deterred. They started out by brainstorming ideas to create a huge number of potential storyboards. Part 2, filming. Caption. First thing that has to be done is to create the locations for the shoot. Finances wouldn't always allow real locations to be used, so sometimes studios were used. Being a lighting technician isn't just about making the subject well lit. You must ensure that there are no harsh shadows, no unintentional reflections or glare, as well as getting the correct exposure. The cameraman is responsible for capturing every moment. If the director calls for a change in shot, he must act quickly and always make sure to adjust the focus and aperture appropriately. The sound crew must record every whisper except those that the director doesn't want to hear. Being able to pick and choose what sounds to record in a potentially noisy location is a difficult skill. But the crew did a great job. Requiring several different locations and featuring many dynamic shots, this was a large team effort. The director had an unshakable vision for the advert. and he skillfully encouraged all members of the crew to use every ounce of their talents.
Part 3, post-production.
Post-production is a time-consuming process. Hours of footage has to be reviewed, and only the best shots make it to the final cut. Let's see what Chief Editor Flo has to say.
Hi, my name is Flo, and I'm in charge of the editing for this project. Martin, the director, and myself decided to make this film a film noir in black and white, quite stylish. So what we did, we gave it this very solitary atmosphere with the sportsman honing his skills throughout. Then, well, basically I used Adobe Premiere Pro to do the editing. The result I think looks pretty good, but it's for you guys to judge it. So I'll let you watch it, and remember, drink hard.
Every morning, I wake up thinking, what makes me come this far? I run hard. I train hard. I study hard. Give it here, and don't say nothing. Just give it here, and don't say nothing. Say nothing. Check with the blunt, don't clap with the man. Hold on, let the thing, cut the check. I play hard. I drink hard. Drink hard.
We've shown you the key points in the long, complicated process of shooting a television advert. Although it was hard work and tensions were often high, it was a lot of fun. We hope you enjoy watching it as much as you enjoyed making it. So take care and stay safe.